Minneapolis, city by nature. It takes a city with this many amazing attractions and this much excitement to be home to one of the biggest, coolest, and most elusive celebrities on earth. I am, of course, speaking of the artist formerly known as someone else. Yes, even his name is elusive, and he's as stylish and cutting edge as this bag from Thin Style. I love it. But though he may be difficult to find, stories about him are not.
Rumor has it, he came to the Home and Garden Show and taught an impromptu workshop on how to properly operate a lathe.
Rumor has it, he comes here when he wants to unwind because he's feeling too awesome, and when he does, the flames turn purple.
Rumor has it, he came here one night to eat, then he worked the valet stand all night just for fun. That dude parked a Winnebago like a Jedi.
The stories of his sightings are almost as exciting as the city itself. All one has to do is log on to go.minneapolis.org and check out our fantastic discount offers for dining, attractions, and entertainment. And a whole host of new stories can be discovered.
His ghost still haunts this place.
All right, can we lose the light? But he's still alive.
That's how ahead of his time he is.
Well, rumor has it every time he eats here, within 3 days, a waiter gets asked to be on the Price is Right.
That seems random.
Well, it happens enough they send me to Macy's to do price checks once a month. Who's random now?
He's one of the world's foremost authorities on historic water-powered mills. And the explosions that destroyed them.
Do you ever consult him for research?
Oh, I'd like to, but you have to complete a quest. And I'm not worthy.
He bought tickets for our entire Broadway series, including Aida, Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, the musical, and Mary Poppins. But not for himself, for the penguins in the new exhibit at the Minnesota Zoo. They need booster seats!
Minneapolis is a city with so much to offer, it may be impossible to track down the artist formerly known as someone else. But as long as there are those with a sense of adventure, the quest will continue.
Rumor has it he used to lean against this wall at First Ave while he was filming his first movie. And I know this sounds crazy, but no matter how cold it gets, this patch of brick sees a constant 98.6 degrees. I'm serious. Touch it. Man, I love this town.
Like, what?
That was a little more Alice Cooper and a little
construction.